Ever wish that you had a cymbal inside of a guitar amp? Me too. Well, that was fun. Maybe not very practical, but it was pretty fun. Spoiler alert, that amp does not sound very good. If you guys leave enough comments, maybe I'll make a video so you can hear it. But we started with a Crate BX50 and then we threw a $9 cymbal into it. So, you know, it's not great. But that's not what we're here for today. Today, it is all about Gong Amp by AudioThing. So Gong Amp is a real thing that somebody made in 1932, and it was a basically experimental amp that somebody did pretty much what I did, maybe with a little more finesse, but it wasn't really made to be like a plate reverb. So going into this, that's something I want to kind of set up. This is something that's made really for intense sound design. So if you are a sound designer for film, or if you like to get really in depth with your sound design on different sounds in your productions, which, come on, we all do, this thing might be up your alley. So a little more history on the plugin. This company called EOWave knew about this experimental amp that was built in the 30s, and they decided to remake that thing. And here is EOWave's site. They were remaking the original Gong amp, putting it in a wood cabinet, and there's, you know, the cymbal and all of that. They actually made physical units. They made them in small batches from 2011 until 2018, and then they decided not to do it anymore. Before that happened, though, the composer named Heinbach was able to get one, and he decided that we needed a plug-in of it. Glad he did. So here it is, Gong Amp. It has chains and a pillow and a big cymbal resonating. It's pretty awesome. So let's dive in here. I have a session pulled up with some sounds I think would be cool for it. And we'll just go over the interface here. So at the top, we've got a picture of the amp, and we've got three selections for different types of things that we can throw on top of the cymbal. Here are some chains. We've got some beaded chains. And then we've got a pillow. Pretty cool. Lots of options. Then if we look over to the right, we have a performance section. There's low and high dynamic, so we can change how hard we're hitting the cymbal or the amp. To the right of that, we have pitch, so off, low, and high. Below that, there's a howl section, so if you want to make it really crazy, you can do that. There's some modulation to it. We'll get into it. A trip section below that. And at the bottom, we have a mixer section with drive, a volume for a mono source, and then stereo, and a resonate feature. On the right of that is the master section, dry and wet controls, and this button here is a soft clip, so in case things get crazy and you start clipping the output section of the plugin, it'll start clipping it off in a soft way. So to start with, I have a kalimba sound pulled up. Let's take a listen to how it is without Gong Amp. It's a moody kalimba. Okay, so I've got Gong Amp here. Let's turn it on and just see what happens from the start. Okay. Pretty cool decay on that. All right, I'm going to start by just turning some knobs here. So we're only listening to the mono signal right now, and I'm just going to turn up the drive and mess around with some stuff. Mm-hmm. Okay, so some things I'm noticing right off the bat are it has a pitch to it. So that's something to keep in mind for sure as we go forward. And I want to hear what some of these chains sound like, and then I want to hear this thing in stereo because I bet that's going to be cool. We still have to mess with the resonate feature as well. So let's just start doing some of that. I'm going to take the pillow off. Let's hear these chains. So just starting from where we were. So the beaded chain thing is really cool. That is a neat trick for anybody who doesn't know. If you take a chain like that from, you know, if you have like a lanyard that has some beaded metal chains, whatever, usually on like some key tags, and you tie it around the middle of a ride cymbal, like on the cymbal stand, and just kind of drape it over the cymbal, you get a really cool sizzle that happens. And that's something that a lot of jazz players will use. I love doing that trick, so it's cool that it's in here. And let's take a listen to the pillow without the chain. I think we're going to need a thicker pillow if we want to catch the low pitch stuff, because it's got a much different decay than the high pitch. Definitely modifying the attack and the decay of that sound though. So, okay, there's the pillow. Let's turn on the stereo and take a listen to that. I'm turning off the mono. I love that the drive actually makes it sound like I'm hitting the cymbal with more air from a speaker. That's pretty cool because I feel like the vibration is definitely increasing on that cymbal and it's getting a little bit nuttier and there's more overtones and all that stuff. So they did a very good job there. Let's hear the resonate. Now it's getting creepy. Okay, pillow. So this is really cool for creating some drone effects. I could totally see having some layers of this stuff just underneath tracks and all of that. So very useful for that. We've got one thing left, and that is the trip knob. So Trip basically is going to automate all of our parameters inside of the mixer section. So I turned it on, you can see they're already starting to move. I can also set it to a note value, or I can do a frequency value. So if I want to sync it with the tempo of the track, I can do that in note values or even by bar. Pretty neat. And then the spread is how far apart those knobs are going to go from each other. So if we turn off Trip, set all these guys at the center, you know, roughly just in the same spot, and then I'll turn on Trip, they're all moving together. But then if I increase the spread, they all have an offset from each other, just kind of neat. This might be cool. So let's take a listen to that. And then let's assign a note value to it. We'll do, say, half a bar. Turn off her pillow. Okay, pretty cool. So you can see how this thing would be awesome for doing drone sounds and some really experimental stuff. I have a Celeste part, which is playing the same thing, that we're going to put Gong Amp on. And on this one, I'm going to use a preset that they have in here. As I was going through it, I noticed that warp chords was super cool. So to start with, here is the Celeste by itself. And with Gong Amp on warp chords. So what I'm gonna do is take that and blend it under the dry kalimba and see what I get. And let's bring back Gong Amp on the kalimba without the pillow. Add in the Celeste. Okay, so we're getting something interesting here. And then to top it off, I've got a little modular percussion part. Heinbach says in a video that he loves it on modular. So let's check it out on a drum machine pattern I have coming from modular. Okay, so right off the bat, again, that pillow is really handy for muting it. That's great. Right off the bat, you can hear that it has a tone to it. So you got to be careful that that tone is in the key of your song and it's all sounding good. Maybe it's not in the key of your song and it sounds good anyway. Who cares? So yeah, that's pretty cool for a drum pattern or some kind of synth blippy sound. You can hear how that would be useful. Sound designers are going to get a kick out of this thing. I love plugins like this that try to create something new, and it's, you know, just something that maybe it's really niche and it's only going to be useful every couple months. But there's always that time when you're sitting in a session and you're like, if only I had a Gong amp. Now you don't have to go find a Crate BX50, a $9 cymbal, and kick it into the front of it. You won't hit your feet as much. It's pretty cool. If you guys like the video, make sure you subscribe, leave me a comment down below, and we'll see you on the next one.